How does the available group of free agents affect how their draft decisions might go?
I don't think it's not a very great crop of free agents. Most of the teams have signed their own free agents, players going into free agency to keep them. Mm-hmm. So there's there's a few defensemen available if the Oilers want to go that route. Pittsburgh's got a couple, and Paul Martin and Christian Ehrhoff, if they want to go that route to get one more established defenseman. They might look at the list and say, there's nothing out there. If they can't make a trade for a goaltender, then maybe there'll be a few free agent goaltenders available and they could sign one of those. But I don't think they're going to be hitting any home runs with free agency. And until the Oilers win anything, there's still not a lineup of players wanting to play in Edmonton. And even if Connor McDavid's here, I don't know if there's going to be a lineup of free agents that want to play in Edmonton.
I think it might have a little bearing, but at the end of the day, the players want to win. David Perron played here. He loved Edmonton, loved playing with the team, but there was no one more excited than David Perron when he got traded to Pittsburgh because he knew he had a far better chance of making the playoffs with that team.